The major part of marketing for any company is either the LinkedIn group or the LinkedIn pages. So why we go for LinkedIn groups, as this is not the proper method to reach out to your audience, but as a group, it has a targeted audience, as well as a lot of information will be there which can interest the user who are interested into that product, and they can come to your group as well, and provides a forum for discussion of relevant issues, create a community for developing introductions and referrals. That is the biggest reason you are developing actually a community which is for developing introductions between people, and referrals you can create out of it. And a word of caution that you always have to take is there are thousands of groups on LinkedIn. So setting one up is very easy, but building a community of people, it's not that easy. You have to spend a lot of time and effort, and it is a long-term thing which you have to do. It is never easy to build a group. So what, before diving into it, you should know, will your group have something new to offer which earlier group, none of the group is offering before it? Second, is there any audience for it? Whether if you are making for Bissell, so what a Bissell group can give to the user? You cannot make a group like Bissell products and services, because nobody is interested on professional network to get associated with a Bissell product and services group. What new you can offer, like manager offer, you can say office cleaning and house cleaning products, which sounds more, how you can make the groups by giving the different titles to it related to cleaning. Okay, make your office hygienic. How you can make the office hygienic and then share the post related to it instead of just making a Bissell group. Okay, there will be no person will be interested in it because it's a product and services. Everyone will be knowing that. But if you make the group like a hygienic office and homes, then it will attract the user how they can make the office hygienic and their homes hygienic. That is what it will be considered as. And second thing, is there an audience for it? Sure, if there are a lot of professionals are there, so there are many HRs and everyone is there, so there is a huge audience for you as well. Will you have a regular and a topical content to contribute that is discussion worthy? You have to talk about regularly. It is not about just posting occasionally. You have to have a proper dedicated time you have to give it and the content so that people can discuss on it. It is not about just posting the content. It is more about discussions as well with the members. So how you can increase that and how you can write those discussions where people can give their views as well. Is your audience the type to engage over social media? That is again a very crucial question. Is that audience which you're talking about is ready to engage over social media? They're ready. That is the biggest question you have. So if you have the answer of all these four questions, then you start a group. Otherwise, do not start. Or the alternative for that, if you are not take the risk of spending a huge amount of money, huge amount of time and effort into it, you can become the part of the group and create the discussions over there, a bit of discussions where already a lot of members are there. Okay, and create the discussions and then try to move the discussions from that group to your group as well. Okay, that trick you can play with, but initially you have to be like first 20 days or 30 days, you have to spend time with the people in the group which you are joining. Which is related to your industry or your what you are offering. Okay, and then try to move the user database from that group to your group as well. So that is the alternative way to do that. So plan your LinkedIn group. The first thing is purpose. What do you want to give people? What exactly the purpose of it? What exactly you want to give it? It's not about product and services because everyone can buy it. What extra you can give it to them? What is the value of that group will be? What do you want members to get out of it or yourself get out of it? That is the first question. The second question, who is going to be interested in joining the group? How you will invite them? How will others hear about it? First, you can invite your connections, but how will you expand it? How the others people will get invited or get invite? That is the second question. So you have to work around that. Then the third thing is name. Avoid using firm names, thinking of a name that accurately describe the purpose and focus of the group. Okay, as I've already told you have to never give the name as the company name or the organization name, never. After that, once you set up the group, then you have to select the type of group. It will be a corporate one, networking, professional, or another category. I will be showing how to make the groups as well. Let's first go through all these points as well. Okay, then the next point is management. Who is going to be the owner and who will be the managers of the group? Because it cannot be managed by a single person because there are so many discussions keep on going every time. It is not easy to manage the groups. So you can own it, but for managing it, you will be requiring people who can go into interactive discussions with the people. Third is access type. Will you allow auto join or request to join? There are two types of requests how people join the group is. One is auto join. Once they clicked on it, they want to join the group, they can automatically join the group. Second is request mode. So what type of access you will be giving to the people? The preferred way is when you are starting the group, you will allow all the people to auto join. Because the reason is in starting, if you have limited number of people, you don't want to lose out any of the member of the group. And then when your group grows like 10,000 people around, then you can restrict people from joining it, and it should like be a more authenticated group so that they have to send the request to join. Okay, because they are getting some value out of it. For getting the value out of it, you have to request. So that is the way how we plan out the administration part. Now in the content part, logo optional or but advised. As logo appears in the directories or on the group pages, so logo should be there. As you are not giving the organization name, but you can use the logo of the organization over there so that your brand recall value remain with the content as it is shared by the organization as well. So you keep on putting the logo so that your brand value keep on increasing with that group as well. The next thing is summary. You have to tell them what is the brief about the group and its purpose. And that is the content you have to write while making the groups. Okay. And that will be visible for the user before joining the group. And even after joining the group, they can see. And if you write a good description about the group, then people will surely join. If you don't write the summary of the group or very small summary, lot of people do not join after reading the summary as well. So you have to be very perfect with it whenever you are writing a summary for the group. And a description, which is a full description that will appear on your group page. When somebody join it, enter into it, a full page description he can see when he joined the group. So that is might sometimes it's the guidelines what you have to post on the group. Like earlier I have talked about creating a group, it's quite difficult thing, and collecting the members. So most of the people join the groups to promote their products. Okay, so you have to give them the guidelines what exactly you can share on this group or not, because you don't want to publicize somebody else's content on your group, because you have catered a lot of people with a lot of efforts. Okay, that is the reason you have to give them the full description how they have to behave on the group. Then creating a LinkedIn group, login into LinkedIn group owners, use your personal profile always, because there is no option of creating a group with the company profile. Okay, then move cursors. Let me show it to you. If I go on the groups interest, then you go on to the groups. Okay, there is an option. There is an option like create a group. Like I have already a lot of members and conversations are there in the group as well, which I already have. Okay, so you can create the group, click on it. Then you have to select the logo which will be visible to the user, like this one. Okay, you have to select the logo. Preferred is the company logo, and you should have the authentication as well to create that, to use that logo as well. Because most of the people, what they do is they use somebody else's logo. Okay, like you can create group like hygienic office and homes. Now is the summary. Summary is like this one. We are here to help digital marketing beginners to learn from very basics to advanced stuff of digital marketing, starting from these things. We will let you to learn through the group. Okay, and every day we keep on sharing different contents on it to our users. So first you have to look for the summary. Like I have in this group, if I'm talking about, this is the group which I have made earlier. I have already helped 25,000 people till now from 110 different countries to pass their exam in Google Analytics. Our expertise in distance learning provide the perfect vehicle for sharing the learning material that we had prepared whilst studying for AdWord exam, and that for the beginning of a beautiful relationship that is blossomed into everything we are today. Okay, I really do not share till now anything on it, but the group, about the group or the summary should be like that, so that whenever somebody read out, it should be very clear what exactly he's going to get out of this group. Like similar in this particular group as well. What this group is all about, you have to be very clear about it. And a very clear summary. It should not be talking about the arbitrary things or the abstract. It should be exact figures, testimonials kind of thing should be there. Okay. And after that, there is the description. Description you have to write, and that description will be visible to the user once they join the group. Let me show you the descriptions as well, and let me approve some discussions as well. that is not visible right now. It will be visible to the user. It is not visible to the owners as well of the group. So you will be seeing the description after it, but it is the full page description, generally the guidelines, how they have to behave on the group as well. Okay, so let me just copy right now what the content is over here. Okay, and your website, so that people can move from the group to the website as well. Like, they have the options to move out. Okay, so you can write down your website as well over there. After that, your email ID through which you want to make the group. If you're making the group private, okay, then you make it unlisted so that it will not be searchable group. I would not recommend you should do it, okay, at all. Then you have to agree to the terms. Language you can select over here, and the option is the group is based in a single geographic location that you have to select. If you want to restrict it to the region, then you will select a single location and then give the locations as well. But I would not recommend you to do that. And in the pre-approved list of domain names, that is a good idea so that people get instant login into it. That is how we do it is. Like most of the people in the world over have the Gmail ID. So pre-approval we will give to them, to those who have Gmail IDs. Yahoo IDs, that is yahoo.com or Rediff mail. Okay, generally we try to give approval to those people who have all these IDs with them or the extension of the email ID. Like my ID was j.bindle66@gmail.com. So most of the people who are online who's using email IDs or email services, most of them are using either Gmail or Yahoo, or even people are using Outlook. So you can give the approval to them directly. They don't have to take the approval from you. If they have the extension like this one, it will be get approved automatically. So you don't have to worry. Most of the people will be joined automatically, and rest you have to confirm. Then after that, you click on create the group. Oh, the content has... The maximum content length that I forgot to tell you is 300 characters in summary. Okay, that you have to do. And after that, now you can invite the people. When you start, you can directly invite the people as well. You can invite through email addresses. Okay, or you can invite all your connection based on the industry you have right now. So when you click on it, it will be asking for the invites. Oh. Okay, you can invite the people according to the location. You can invite people according to the industry, but in one you can mark maximum 50 people. Okay, in one go you can mark only 50 people at a time. Like I have approximately 12,000 connections, but I can send the invitation to 50 people in one go. I have to select then 50 people in next time. Like this, I have to invite people. Okay, because to avoid spamming, LinkedIn has done this way. Earlier there was an option to check all the names, but now it is no more existence. Okay, you cannot select the people directly. Okay, you have to select it one by one and then do it. Let me invite two people. And the message will be Jatin invites you to join hygienic homes and hygienic offices and homes on LinkedIn. Would you like to invite you to join the group on LinkedIn? The message will be that. You can send the message. Okay, it will be sent from your personal profile. Okay, or you can even skip this step as well. And your group is ready. Okay, and your group is ready. Now what you have to do, you can post anything. You can share the jobs as well. And the conversation, and what type of conversation you can share over here is, let me first summarize this one, then I will be summarizing how to promote it. Okay, once you make the group, send out the personal invitations, ask people to invite members of their network. One to one in LinkedIn you have to go. There is you don't in a group, you cannot promote the group directly. Okay, so like I have 12,000 connections with me, so I can send invitations to all of them. So there will be around, out of 12,000 people, there are chances that 1% people will join my group. So 1% will be around 1200 people will surely join my group out of those 12,000. Okay, that is the first way. Then second way is ask connection to invite members of their network. Okay, give some value like this so that they should invite the members of their networks as well. Like how I started is like I give them freebies, like $50 WordPress theme for free, or how you can make the website. If you invite 100 people, I will mail you the thanks over that. If you are able to invite 50 people of yours, so people start doing it, and it will start getting more and more members in your group, and you can share few things with them, few articles. It could be anything. You have to give them value. What value you can give them when they are inviting their friends or their people in the network. Okay, and approve members who find the group and ask you to join. That is the key. Generally, in starting, we at any stage of the group, we never restrict people to join the group. Never. Then start valuable discussions with them. Regular updates, manage discussion threads, interact with Google group members by commenting on their discussions and comments. Okay, you as a group owner, how you manage the group is you have to interact with the group members by commenting. Like somebody got the job, so you have to update in the group. So our group member got the job. Okay, congratulate him. So that he can feel that he's the part or he's getting the limelight of the group as well. Like there are hundreds of people on it, so that they can become the part of the discussions, and he can really go into the group and put all his effort, which he might not do unless and until you give him the limelight. Okay, by this way you can interact with the peoples, or even you can comment. Whenever somebody comment on the discussions, you try to comment with them, along with them. The next thing is react quickly to questions. That is the biggest thing in a group, in LinkedIn group. You have to react to the questions instantly. So there will be somebody who will be regularly on this LinkedIn group present, so that whenever there is anything is asked, or you keep on posting different questions even. Okay, so that people can interact with you. Like how I interact with people is I share articles, I share questions, like the question in the quality score, what is the importance of landing page optimization? Is there any relevance or not? if you feel yes, then what are the things which should take care while doing the landing page optimization? Okay, and I already know the answer as a group owner. I have been expert into it, but still, people always like they want to answer each and every question which is there on the net. They feel good about it. So let them to do that kind of discussions. Let them to become the part of the questions as well. Okay, so that they can become the part of your discussions and more interaction will be there and they will be later on ask their questions as well on it. And the most important point is delete any discussions or comments which are inappropriate. Do not engage or do not tell them that do not post this, do not post this. Simply delete the discussion which is irrelevant to your topic or the comments which is irrelevant to your topic. Do not tell them that you do not post kind of thing. Simply delete it. Okay. Ensure all the information is relevant. Whatever content you are sharing with people, that should be relevant. It should not be random content. Like we are talking about making office hygienic and homes healthy. How you can do that? Okay. And how you can talk about the topics like what type of cleaning facilities are available at your offices? Which is the best office in Europe? Which is the cleanest office in Europe when there are thousands of people are there on the group or hundreds of people are there? So people start clicking, I am from this office and this is the good group actually, and this is the best office, this is the cleanest office I feel, and they will start posting their images as well in the discussions. When you start getting the response, you have to tell them and declare some winner and try to move on. It's not about gifting, it's about getting engaged. Okay, then set up group rules stating with what happen if messages are irrelevant and promotional. You can tell them also, okay, in the group summary or even the in the setup rules as well. Okay, in the welcome mail that I will be telling you. Let me show you that as well, how we set up group rules and all. You click on manage. Okay. That is the about the standards. Here is the option of group rules. Okay, you can write the list of group rules, like what kind of content you can post them, what kind of content you cannot post. Okay, and keep on writing discussions as well. Okay, and the template over here, request to join. Okay, welcome message, you can define that even. It is not about sending the normal request, create and automatically send a custom message to people to request. You can create the template, request to join the message. Okay, even the welcome message you can give to them, like how I invite people is, like I have already told you, is I give them the freebies, like the WordPress theme of $50 for them for free, or how to build the blog in just 10 minutes or 20 minutes and or in 5 minutes. So I write the mail and I give the link of my blog where I have written the content, how to build the blog in just 5 minutes. And you enable the welcome template and you can send them. It will be very easy for you to collect the user. And when generally we do not decline, as I have already told you, we do not decline the user, except the user which are just coming here to promote their product every time. They whatever they post is always the promotional content. So what we do with them is block and remove them from the group. There are a lot of members which do that, so we have the direct thing with them. Okay, and the important thing about this is change the group owner. Okay, I can if you are like how we switch the owners, like this company, it is can be owned by only the group can be owned by the individual, not the company. So whoever take the responsibility, we change the ownership from here. And the members who will be maintaining the group, who will be helping you out, as you are the owner, you cannot manage everything. So you can invite people, like those people who are in the group. If you go on and you select moderator or manager, you have the option what he can do. Requires moderation or approval to post or not. You can give the permissions from here. And third is blocked. You can add the people and block it from here. And request to join if you want, like in the first time you are not able to send it, you can send it from here. And pre-approval groups, I have already told you the email IDs and all. Send invitations later on. If you want to send invitation to people, you can send it from here. And anything is there in the group which requires the approval of yours. Okay. So that will be here, coming here, or the job somebody sharing over here, or anything inappropriate you marked, that will be removed from the group as well. Okay, the next thing is promoting the group. This is very, very important. Promoting a group, post a status, like you have invited all your friends already. Okay, so what else you can do is you can post a status update about the launch of the group in different formats. Like in the first week you talk about, I have launched a group for digital marketing beginners. Learn digital marketing at free of cost, and all the tutorials will be given to the people who will be joining the group. Okay, and there will be a lot of people joining the group. How you can encourage, if you share this with you want your friends should learn at free of cost, you can share the group or share this status so that people can start sharing it. Continue on looking out people to invite. It is not one time that you invite people, you keep on inviting people. Whenever you are getting new connections, try to invite as soon as possible. Okay, then after that, consider making the group discussions public. Do not make the discussions private. The reason why we make the group discussions public is, if you make the group discussions public and if any of the member is commenting on it, then what happens is that will be shared on his activities, or will be shared on the wall of his all connections. Okay, and your group will start getting popularity out of it. Like if somebody comment anything on the discussions, that will be shared with all his connections, or will be visible on the connections wall. So that will help to grow your group as well. Promote the group on the firm website as well, so that you get more and more people joining. Promote the group through all the social media account, that is known as cross-selling. This is the term known as cross-selling. You have different channels like Facebook, you have Twitter, you have LinkedIn, you have Pinterest, you have Instagram, you have nowadays Periscope. This is a new application. You have YouTube. These are the some social media channels. If you have n number of followers on any of the social media accounts, you update the status. Like we have a LinkedIn group which is about sharing your thoughts on it, so people will be surely joining it. Okay, like if 10,000 people are there on the Facebook group, if 1% or like 0.1% people join it, there will be an increase of 100 people on the group. That is the way to promote. And promotion is a long effort after it is launched. It is a very long process. In LinkedIn, it's not easy. Like you can see my group is having 21 people around. Actually, I do not put a lot of effort to promote it, but yes, it requires a great effort from people to promote the group on LinkedIn. It's not easy. Like in Facebook, it's quite easy. If you give them the value, it's easy. But if you're not giving any value to the user, then it is impossible to promote the group.